Welcome back to the Brazilian MBA guest. And today I have the honor to receive again a very good fellow of mine, Vince Mirabelli. Hi, Vince. How are you, my friend?
I am great, buddy. How you doing?
I'm very fine and very happy that you are here again so soon. That's
anytime,
very nice.
Anytime. Anytime. Nice.
Vince, the question for you today is, what's the connection between Lean Six Sigma, business analysis, and agile?
Oh, boy. That is how much time do I have?
You have about 5 minutes.
I have 5 minutes. So there are significant connections between the two, and or between the three rather. And I think what it really ties to is the fact that they're all going towards the same goal, which is delivering value for your customers. Now, your customers could be internal, they could be external, but in the end, those three disciplines are really concerned with maximizing value. How they do it is a little bit different, but in the end, that is what is important about those three. And so, you know, I am a big advocate for having multiple quivers in your, or arrows in your quiver, because I don't talk about this too much, but I do it sometimes when I'm speaking at events. Like, I have certifications in business analysis, project management, Lean Six Sigma, change management, customer experience, Lego Serious Play, like a bunch of different disciplines. And it's not because I'm not focused. It's actually because each one allows me to solve problems in a slightly different way. And so if all I know is business analysis, then I'm going to solve problems like a business analyst. Now, between you and me, of all of the disciplines I have certifications in, business analysis is probably the most complete from just being able to solve issues. But a close second is Lean Six Sigma and the way that you can apply statistical analysis to quantify your problem, to quantify the impacts, to identify your critical inputs and then correct them is massive. But when you can put those two together, it's 1 + 1 = 3. They compound. Now, let's add the discipline of agile. And I'm going to be honest with you, I am not an agilist by any means, but I appreciate the methodology and the discipline and the thought that comes from agility and being able to move and pivot and having that mindset of delivering value and testing products and iterating and constantly evolving the product or the process or the project that you're working on. It just compounds again. So if you can put those disciplines together, you can become a much more effective business analyst, which I mean, that's sort of what we're all interested in, right?
For sure. And if we follow the path that you started with, that the three disciplines are looking for the same goal or for the same objective that is creating value, could I say that business analysis is the discipline that understand what is valuable, how can I deliver value, understanding the need and trying to understand different solutions? And Lean Six Sigma would be the way to measure value, and not just value, but measure how important the problem is, how the solutions are available, can solve that need. And agile would be a way to systematically build or deliver this solution in small increments of a product that we could learn and again measure it again and understand better the needs and reevaluate our hypothesis and learn it. So whole three can work very well together, as you said, a lot of arrows in your how do you call that,
the quiver.
I
don't know, it's I got it from Robin Hood. I don't know.
Oh, that's great.
But
that's
see,
great.
Like you, what you just said is like, what do you need me for? You just covered it. Because
no, I just learned it from. I was just doing my job as a business analyst, trying to understand.
I see. No, but you're right, right? Because there are things that like a Lean Six Sigma sort of purist, they're not so concerned. Like they recognize the need for people, but it's more about people adopting change and bringing change and accepting change. When they look at inputs into a problem, it's sort of agnostic of people, and so they look at it very, you know, with sort of blinders on. It's like this is what it is. The really good one, and that's if you just follow sort of the dogmatic discipline. I think the really good ones are doing business analysis. They're understanding that, you know, you have stakeholders that are going to impact your ability to deliver. You have organizational challenges that you're going to have to overcome from leadership, from staff, from all over the place. So, you know, to have those two disciplines and be able to do that work is really, really important. I was a business analyst before I went and became a Lean Six Sigma Master Black Belt. And I think that was important because I don't know if I would have been the same, if I would have solved problems the same way if I had done them the other way, right? So I was a business analyst first. And then I went and learned how to solve problems and by identifying inputs and critical X's and using statistical analysis. But I already had the stakeholder management piece and that piece of delivering value and solving problems through the business analysis lens. So I think, yeah, those three disciplines are very complementary. And I think, you know, just from a personal development standpoint, it makes sense that if you are a business analyst, you know, it doesn't hurt you. It can only help you to learn, you know, Lean Six Sigma, to learn about Agile and learn how to incorporate that to make you much more effective.
Very interesting. And I see from an external point of view, people that are coming to the professional right now, and they are learning Agile as the first discipline, let's say, from these three ones, they just learning Agile. And sometimes they think that they can throw away everything that happened for Agile because Agile has all the answers for them.
Agile is perfect and it's the best, and we should all hail Agile.
Yes, and there is that's all. So I believe Agile needs the measurement that Lean Six Sigma can bring. And Agile definitely needs the definition of value that business analysis can help you understand.
Absolutely.
I like your profession.
You know what? And it's really, really cool because it gives me a unique view of the work that I do and the way that I solve problems. Many, many years ago, a former leader of mine just said that I solve problems like a criminal, which I think was a compliment, but it was about seeing all of the angles and solving a problem sort of three-dimensionally so that if I'm looking at a problem, it's not just this way, but I'm also able to replicate myself and put myself around the problem and look at it. If I had to describe it as just to give a visual, it's that whole six thinking hats strategic perspective of like, I'm going to put on the red hat and now I'm going to look for problems. Now I'm going to put on the white hat and I'm only going to look for opportunities. But instead of doing it that way, it's actually solving it like, well, from a business analysis perspective, this is what I think. And from this perspective, and from this perspective, from the change perspective, and then being able to sort of run through all the different scenarios and come up with a solution. Sort of like Doctor Strange in the Marvel movies, in the Avengers, right? Where he goes in when they're fighting Thanos. If you haven't seen it, like, you know, it's been out for a few years, so spoilers. But like he sits and he's like, there's only one scenario out of a million in which we beat Thanos. And it's because he's going and looking at all of these different perspectives to solve problems. And you know, we don't have to do that because we're not fighting a galactic supervillain. But having those perspectives, particularly of business analysis and lean and agile, is really, really valuable because it's you're going to solve problems different than other folks.
Love it. Love it. I believe we can create the Agamotto-Eye analysis. Wasn't that the name of the stone he had? Agamotto-Eye? Something like that, and he could see the future.
I don't remember the names. It was the
I'm probably stone. More nerd than you are.
No, it's fine. It was the green stone, though. It was the green stone. That's as much as I know. It was the green one.
Right. That's great. For people who wants to know more about you, where do can find it?
So the best place to check me out is at my my website, vincentmirabelli.com. But I want to recommend a second site if I can, because I think it's very applicable today. I actually have, because of the pandemic situation that we've been in 2020 and beyond, I've actually moved my Six Sigma training online. And so you can go to lovetheprocess.academy, and you can actually take my yellow belt course. The green belt will be coming soon, but you can take a Lean Six Sigma yellow belt there on demand whenever you're ready. So I would say go there. But vincentmirabelli.com also links out to that. So check out both. They're both awesome.
For sure. And we are going to left the links on the description beside below this video, so it's even easier if you just want to click there, or if you are seeing another platform that's not clickable, we just show it here, Jimmy.
Just pause the video and then type it in.
Vince, thank you very much. It was a very great pleasure to have you here.
Anytime, my friend. Anytime. Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.